Senator Barrasso, Wyoming's doctor. I have a question for you. Because your Republican Party, the majority party, I guess that means you guys get to be all the chairman of all of the committees in Congress, too. Isn't that a big win for you guys? It just so happens that you are the chairman of the Council on Indian Affairs. So, why haven't we heard from you about the Dakota Access Pipeline project at all? Why have we heard from the Department of the Interior, the president? But we haven't heard from Steve Barrasso from Wyoming, have we? On the United States Senate Committee on Indian Affairs page, that's www.indian.senate.gov, we have a press release. This November 17th, gosh, this wasn't very long ago, right before Thanksgiving. U.S. Senator John Barrasso, that would be you, chairman of the Senate Committee on Indian Affairs, introduced a Senate resolution to recognize the month of November as National Native American Heritage Month. The resolution celebrates the heritage, culture, and history of Native Americans and recognizes the many contributions Native Americans have made to our nation. Tribal sovereignty, cultures, histories, and traditions are an integral part of our national identity, said Barrasso. National Native American Heritage Month celebrates the many contributions Native Americans have made to the United States. I am proud to join with so many other senators in sponsoring this resolution to recognize these many contributions and to affirm the government-to-government relationship the nation shares with tribes. And look, you've got all of these other senators that also wanted to stand and recognize the important relationship and contributions of the indigenous people to the United States of America, the ones that were here first. So that was really nice of you. That was just like a couple weeks ago. Given that press release on the Senate's page, it sounds like you really have the interests of the indigenous people at heart. So I'm a little confused about this other article here. LastRealIndians.com. On September 14th, Senator Barrasso refuses hearing on Standing Rock Sioux Tribe opposition to the Dakota Access Pipeline. Washington, D.C., representatives of the International Indigenous Youth Council of Standing Rock and Ossetee-Sakowin Youth Encampment have requested that Senator John Barrasso hold a Senate committee hearing on Indian affairs in response to the Standing Rock Sioux Tribe's opposition to the Dakota Access Pipeline. That's a great idea. As the 114th congressional session is coming to an end, the window of opportunity is closing to give notice to other senators, as required by Procedural Rule 4A for the Indian Affairs Committee. Senator Barrasso's legislative director, Bryn Stewart, advised Youth Council representatives on Wednesday, September 14th, 2016, a little over 2 months ago, that in order for Barrasso to schedule a hearing, he needed requests from other senators to do so. However, according to Senator Tester, D. Montana, this isn't the case. And Barrasso can immediately schedule a hearing on the impact the Dakota Access Pipeline construction is having and will have on Indian country. On Friday, September 16th, the Indigenous Youth Council confronted Senator Barrasso, and they were informed that the senator would not be calling a hearing. You refused. That doesn't really jibe to me. Here you are on November 17th honoring the Native Americans in this heartfelt speech or whatever the hell it was. But on September 14th and September 16th, 2016, you were not even entertaining the idea to have a hearing. They had kids there that wanted a hearing, and you wouldn't even talk to them. It sounds like you sent Bryn Stewart to do your dirty work, and they caught up to you anyway. They caught your ass, probably coming out of a back door somewhere. Barrasso's legislative director, Stewart. We're back to Bryn Stewart now. Told the Youth Council representatives that Senator Barrasso has other priorities than Standing Rock Sioux Tribe's opposition to the Dakota Access Pipeline. This dismissal comes at a time when nearly 300 Native tribes have rallied in support with the Standing Rock Sioux, and this issue has garnered national and international attention, including solidarity protests in 40 states and worldwide. The Standing Rock Sioux Tribe and Native and non-Native allies have raised particular concern about desecration of historical sacred sites and burial grounds. And a lot of the concern also comes from the fact that energy transfer partners are required to consult the Indigenous people before they even start on these projects. But they didn't at all. They got the plans together and they then announced it. And they then said, okay, now you guys can see what we're going to do anyway. And this was back in, what, October of 2014? And back then, the Standing Rock and everyone else said, no, thank you. We don't approve of that. And it doesn't seem to have mattered at all, because the Army Corps of Engineers has fast-tracked that pipe and shoved it right up the middle of America. And right up yours to the Standing Rock and any other tribes that are involved in this. And then you have Senator Steve Barrasso, the chairman of the Council on Indian Affairs, who doesn't have time. He's got more important things to do than worry about your stupid pipeline. Now, apparently the federal government, because this is an oil and not natural gas, there was no requirements that the federal government had to be involved. I don't know. I guess there's some little like slippery slope there. So there weren't any permits or oversight. Really, the federal government was not involved in this at all until, you know, now, until it's gotten as big as it has. And like I said, we've heard from the Department of Interior. We've heard from President Obama. We have not heard from you. So what the hell are you doing on that committee? Because you sure as hell are not looking out for the interests of the Indigenous people or their lands, which is what your job title says as chairman of the Council on Indian Affairs. So what are you doing there? Because your page says lots of glowing things about all the ways that you are standing up for the Native Americans. And obviously you know how to give really great speeches and make sure they're posted in just the right place online so that if anyone was to look, they could see all these wonderful things that you do. But I don't buy it. John Barrasso has a long and distinguished career in both medicine and public service. In 2012, Barrasso was re-elected to the U.S. Senate with over 75% of the vote to represent his home state of Wyoming. In January 2015, he was elected chairman of the Senate Committee on Indian Affairs. As chairman, he is focused on measures related to jobs, energy and natural resource development, healthcare, education, and tribal self-governance. That didn't say shit about what you're supposed to be doing, nor has it listed anything that you've done besides write like really nice letters to nobody, because it sounded like just you and a bunch of senators just were like, congratulations us for putting together this really nice note after we just said F you, Standing Rock, just a couple weeks ago. In 1977, the Senate reestablished the Committee on Indian Affairs, making it a temporary select committee. It was to disband at the close of the 95th Congress, but following several term extensions, the Senate voted to make it permanent on June 6, 1984. The committee has jurisdiction to study the unique problems of American Indian, Native Hawaiian, and Alaskan Native people, and to propose legislation to alleviate these fucking difficulties. These issues include, but are not limited to, Indian education, economic development, land management, trust responsibilities, healthcare, and claims against the United States. Additionally, all legislation proposed by members of the Senate that specifically pertains to American Indians, Native Hawaiians, or Alaska Natives is under the jurisdiction of the committee. So what the fuck are you doing with your seat as chairman of this committee? Because you sure as hell ain't in North Dakota. You're not talking about North Dakota. You're writing all kinds of glowing letters about absolutely fucking nothing, but you are not helping these people. So what the hell are you doing? What are you doing with your chairman seat? Another thing that you're supposed to do is to help protect the land and the culture of the Native American people. That's part of this job. But you don't seem to like the EPA very much, the Environmental Protection Agency. The people that are working to help the indigenous people of this country. You don't seem to like anything that they do, actually. really seem to like uranium mining. Funny enough, there are quite a few uranium mines in your home state of Wyoming. Also, Alabama, Alaska, Arizona, California, Colorado, Florida, Idaho, Nebraska, Nevada, New Jersey, New Mexico, North Dakota, Oklahoma, Oregon, Pennsylvania, South Dakota, Texas, Utah, Virginia, Washington, on the Spokane Indian Reservation, and Wyoming. The Powder River Basin, the Smith Ranch Highland In-Situ Leaching Operation in the Powder River Basin, owned by a subsidiary of Cameco. It produced 907 metric tons of yellowcake uranium concentrate in 2006, making it the leading uranium producer in the United States. Wow, your home state. It seems like you are very concerned with uranium, even though you have no time to talk about the Dakota Access Pipeline, but you have plenty of time to spearhead all these efforts that I keep finding. May 23rd, 2016. Washington, D.C. Today, U.S. Senator John Barrasso and a bipartisan bicameral, I've never known how to say that, so oh well, group of 16 other lawmakers from Wyoming, Arizona, Colorado, Nebraska, New Mexico, Texas, and Utah called on the Department of Energy to stop hurting America's uranium producers by flooding the market with excess uranium. I wonder if these other lawmakers that were standing with you were also residents of states with lots of uranium in them. Yes, you do all seem to be from uranium-producing states, all of you senators that are very concerned about this. I haven't heard any of you talking about the Dakota Access Pipeline, and I believe all of you have tribal lands. And if you're such good buddies with Steve, you'd think you guys would all be concerned about things like this, you know? Since 2009, the DOE has paid its contractors over $1 billion in excess uranium in exchange for decommissioning and other services at DOE facilities, an arrangement the Government Accountability Office has repeatedly said violates federal law. In a letter to the Secretary of Energy, Ernest Moniz, the lawmakers expressed their concerns about these so-called barters of excess uranium. Excess again? What the hell does that mean, excess uranium? Just because it's not yours that's being used? I'm guessing that's what excess is. Stop watching any other excess videos on YouTube. Only watch mine, to all my viewers. Why are you hurting me like that and watching those excess videos? The lawmakers explained the barters have contributed significantly to an oversupply of uranium in the world market, in the whole world! DOE is ruining the world! This oversupply in turn hurts uranium producers across the country and has resulted in widespread job losses since December 31st, 2015. The spot price of uranium has fallen by as much as 20%. This drop in prices has resulted in large workforce reductions in the United States, including the elimination of 85 jobs announced by Cameco Resources last month. 85 jobs by the oil company? This is part of your sob story? I can't believe I'm reading this shit. So, here we have Steve Barrasso, who does not give a shit about the Dakota Access Pipeline. Oh, I forgot I'm talking to you, Steve. John Barrasso. You don't give a shit about Dakota Access. You told the youth of Standing Rock and Sioux to fuck off. You care very much about the price of uranium, and you care very much about uranium, period. But what you don't seem to care about is the EPA wanting to check the groundwater around the uranium mines for up to 30 years after drilling to make sure the water is safe. You also spearheaded that little campaign, didn't you? So Wyoming's doctor doesn't think that it's a very wise investment to have the EPA testing the groundwater in his own state after drilling for uranium for up to 30 years. Because it's just too fucking expensive. And you know, nothing really has happened so far. So, we don't need you, EPA. You're always getting in the way. I wonder if the constituents in your state know that. Since you have not only tribal lands all over Wyoming and all the rest of these uranium mined states, but you've got uranium mines all up in the mid-center west all over there. I'm guessing, Steve John Barrasso, that Peter, Emma, and Hadley, and Bobby probably all drink bottled water. Or maybe some super awesome triple quadruple filtration system that you have in your house, which I'm sure you do, since you, Wyoming's doctor, know that you don't give a shit about cleaning up and testing groundwater around the uranium sites. But you were an orthopedic surgeon, so I guess you really didn't have anything to do with those inner workings and poisoning the body and things like that, right? Is an orthopedic surgeon even really a doctor? Is it really a surgeon? And why are there so many orthopedic surgeons and doctors in Congress anyway? Because I keep hearing that one over and over again, and I'm starting to think that's also just a front, like a degree front. One of the biggest reasons that the Standing Rock are so concerned about the Dakota Access Pipeline is that pipes burst all the time, and energy transfer partners are partnered with Sunoco. Energy transfer partners who have been shoving this pipe like straight through America, not giving a shit. Oh, and who rerouted it from Bismarck, the capital of North Dakota. They decided not to go that route because it's too close to Bismarck and the, like, you know, the populated cities. Let's take it and stick it over closer to the reservation instead. Who was it, Jesse Jackson? I gotta agree. That is environmental racism. Way to go. Y'all have figured out how to pull that one off, and you did it exactly right. Sunoco Logistics, the future operator of the pipeline, has spilled crude oil from its onshore pipelines more often since 2010 than any other U.S. pipeline operator, with at least 203 leaks disclosed to the Pipeline and Hazardous Materials Safety Administration. That's disclosed. Shit, with that many spills, there are probably a bunch more that ain't nobody know about. That's hearsay. That was just my opinion throwing it in there. But one of the biggest reasons that they are not wanting this pipeline to go through is because pipelines leak. They spill. It doesn't matter how state-of-the-art it is or how many 3 billion whatever dollars it took to build it. Those shits spill all the time. And that water, that pipe could easily get into the Missouri River, not just onto their lands. It could easily get into the Missouri River, which would then have catastrophic consequences, not only for wildlife and fish and the environment, but for people who drink that water. Wyoming's doctor, why aren't you all over this? I think the better question is, why the fuck are you in that chairman position? So, I am speaking on behalf of the Standing Rock and the Sioux and the American people and everyone else sitting out here wondering where the fuck the federal government is. Why has it been thrown to President Obama? When it should be up to you, Steve motherfucking Barrasso. Sorry, I meant John. If you respond to this, if you take some accountability for this, if you do something, if you get off your ass, maybe I'll call you John. I see you. And anybody that sees this video is gonna see you too. You have a choice. You have time. You're in a position you could redeem yourself. Thank you. you are officially called out. You are officially put on notice. And if you don't change your ways, Steve John Barrasso, God is going to cut you down. Consider yourself warned.